video, we're going to be taking a look at the coefficient of determination, or R squared. Okay, coefficient of determination, or R squared. Now, in the last couple of videos where we were talking with linear regression, or talking about linear regression, we were looking at finding the line of best fit for this data here where the x variable represented the, I believe this was the weight of a car in hundreds of pounds, yes, and y was the miles per gallon of that car. So we were examining the relationship between weight and miles per gallon. We saw that it looked roughly linear when we plotted it with a negative relationship, because as weight increases, it appears that miles per gallon tend to decrease. We looked at our correlation coefficient, which measures the strength and direction of the linear relationship between the two variables, and we saw that it was a negative relationship, meaning it's decreasing. Also that it was strong, because that value was pretty close to a negative one. We found the line of best fit here, and then we were looking at using that line to make predictions, right? So we plugged in a value to predict what is the weight, what is the predicted miles per gallon for a car that weighs 2,500 pounds, and we got that prediction, 28.33 miles per gallon, and then we might want to know how accurate we expect the prediction to be. In the last video, we talked about the difference between extrapolating and interpolating, but regardless of which one you're doing, even if you're interpolating, which is a safe thing to do, also the accuracy of your prediction hinges on how well the line fits the data. If the line does not fit the data well, then you can make all the predictions that you want based on that line, but you shouldn't expect them to be very accurate if it's not a good fitting line. So that brings us to this notion of the coefficient of determination. And there are essentially two things that the coefficient of determination, R squared, does for you. The first one is it essentially measures how well your line fits the data. R squared, by contrast to R, R is always expressed as a decimal. R squared will be expressed as a percentage. Your calculator will give it to you in a decimal, but you will want to express it as a percentage. So values closer to 100% indicate better fit. If you ever have an R squared value that's exactly 100%, it means that your model exactly fits your data. But most models won't fit exactly, but closer to 100 indicates a better fit. Everyone has kind of a cutoff. Every analyst does this a little bit differently. Where is a cutoff to indicate that a fit tends to be good? And I've seen textbooks go kind of all over the place with this. The way that I like to think of the coefficient of determination is I tend to think of it as a letter grade. So if we get a 70% to a 79% fit, that's a C minus to a C plus. And that's a pretty good fit. That's about average. Right? If we get something in the 80% to 89%, that's a B minus to a B plus, and 90% to 100%, that's an A minus to an A plus. Okay, let's put that in there, 90%. So obviously we would rather have the 100%, but that's not really realistic. So in that case, we'd rather have the A, which indicates exemplary. B is okay, that's above average. C is average. If you start dropping below a C, if you're getting a line that has a D or an F fit, that's when you really don't want to use that line to make predictions. That would not be considered very accurate. 70% or above is considered adequate in terms of how well the line needs to fit to make predictions. But again, that's not an industry standard. It's not a hard and fast rule. People have differing opinions on that. Okay. So the other thing that the coefficient of determination does for you, aside from measuring how well your line fits the data, is the R squared tells you the percentage of variation in the Y variable that can be explained using the linear model. Or in other words, it can be explained by the x variable. One minus r squared tells us the percentage of this variation due to random chance or lurking variables. Okay, so this is what we know. Now let's go back to our data that we were looking at with the cars. So here, this was our car data. And again, we had here, weight of the car in hundreds of pounds. Here, miles per gallon. If we want to use the calculator to calculate r squared, the calculator actually gives us the r squared value when we run the linear regression. It gives us the equation of the line of best fit. It gives us the r and the r squared all at once. That's actually a really powerful command in the calculator. You get a lot of information. So when I'm looking here, I've already put my data in. In the last video, we talked about going to stat, to calc, down to option 8, either by using the arrow key or just by pressing the number 8, selecting that, doing second 1 for your x data, so list 1, comma, second 2, list 2, comma, then to vars, y vars, select function by pressing enter, and select y1 by pressing enter. So this will compute the line of best fit for the x data in list 1, y data in list 2, and it will store the equation of that line in y1 so that it will show up on top of your graph. And then press enter. And here, we've done things now with the a and the b and the r. Here's our r squared, 0.895. So if we rounded that to two decimal places, we're looking at about 90%. So in this case, whoops, let me move this up here. Our r squared for our data is about 90%. And so what does that mean? First of all, it tells us this is a good fit, right? Actually, it's a really great fit. It's essentially an A- fit. That's really nice. We should feel very confident using this line to make predictions. Provided that we are interpolating. Okay, so if we are interpolating, we would expect our predictions to be pretty accurate because this model does a really good job fitting the data. Our line actually fits the data very well. The other thing that this tells us is it tells us that 90% of the variation in the y variable, which in this case was miles per gallon, can be explained by the x variable, which in this case, the x variable was the weight of the car. And it makes sense when you think about this particular scenario realistically. It's not as though the only thing that determines the variation in miles per gallon is the weight. It doesn't determine 100% of the miles per gallon, right? Other factors go into play, how much you inflate your tires, right? The PSI, how old the car is it well maintained, you know, what model of car, how big is it? All sorts of things go into the miles per gallon. But approximately 90% of that variation in miles per gallon can be explained solely by the weight of the car. This leaves 10% of the variation in miles per gallon due to random chance or lurking variables, such as, again, the size of the car, the age, all of that kind of stuff. Those would be lurking variables. They were things that we didn't collect data about, but that nevertheless could have an influence on the relationship that we're taking a look at. And that's how the coefficient of determination R-squared works. It tells us these two things. How well does the model fit? What percentage of the variation can be explained? Versus what percentage is due to chance or lurking variables. Now, if you're interested in the derivation for the formula of R squared, that's covered in the book. But really the key thing for this class, it's an intro stats class, is being able to obtain this value from the calculator and being able to interpret it correctly.